Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to multiply decimals using a lattice. You need to already understand how to use the lattice method for multiplying with whole numbers, so make sure you know how to do that first. I have a video on multiplying using a lattice. And now we're going to do it with decimals. So here's an example. Let's take 3.21 times 4.6. All right, so we start out the same as if it was just 3.21 times 4.26. Okay, so we can go ahead and put 3.21 times 46. So very similar. Notice I'm just ignoring the decimals here. And I'm going to go ahead and just do my regular lattice. And I'm not going to use cups because it might be a little confusing. I'm just going to go ahead and put the numbers, under the place where they go along the sides. So we have 1 times 4, that's 0, 4, right? And 1 times 6 is 0, 6. 2 times 4 is 0, 8. 3 times 4 is 12. 2 times 6 is 12. And 3 times 6 is 18. Okay, and then we're going to take the numbers in the lattice, remember, along these diagonals, because that's the ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Ten thousands if they're whole numbers. So this is 6. Here I've got 4, 0, and 2, that's a 6. 8, 1, and 8, that's 16 plus 1, that's 17. So I'm going to put 1 over here for the carry, so that's 17. I've got 2, 1, and 1 is 4, and a 1 over here. Now there's two ways of getting the answer and figuring out where the decimal place is. One way is to remember when you multiply decimals, you just multiply the numbers, and what do I get here for the number is 14766, right? If it was whole numbers. So keep in mind, I got 14766. And then remember, you have to see how many digits are after the place values and add them up. I've got two digits plus another digit over here. So I've got three total, so my answer I have to have three digits after, so the decimal's got to go right here. Now, so that's one way of getting it. The other way is to put the decimal right in the lattice. So this way, 3.21, put the one right, I mean put the decimal point here, 3.21, and 4.6, you put the decimal right here. And what you do is you see if this one's going down and this one's going across, where do they meet? Where do the decimal points meet? So this decimal goes down, this decimal goes across, it goes right here. And what you do is you follow the diagonal down, and that is where the decimal goes. So that would be really 14.766, or 14 and 766 thousandths. Let's do it again, but let's put the 4.6 across the top and the 3.21 across the bottom, and we should get exactly the same answer. So we have the same problem, 3.21 times 4.6, except that we're going to put the one with the two digits across the top. Well, I'm going to write this as 4.6 and across the side 3.21. And let's decide where the decimal place is going to go ahead of time this time. So I see the decimal point here and the decimal point here. Where do they meet? Right here. And you follow it down, and that's where the decimal is going to be. So you can figure out the decimal point ahead of time. Now let's go ahead and fill out the lattice. So we have 4 times 3 is 12. 6 times 3 is 18. 6 times 2 is 12. 6 times 1 is 6. Remember to put the 6 down here in the ones place, so it's 0, 6. 4 times 2 is 8. Again, put the 8 here, the 0 there. 4 times 1 is 4, 0, 4. And we drop it into the answer here, so the 6 goes here. 2 plus 4 is 6. 8, 8, and 1 is 17. So remember, I'm going to write 1, 7 for 17. 1, 2, and 1 is 4. And the 1 goes here. And if I read this going around, I get 14.766. Kind of cool. Now, if I had left off the decimal point and just multiplied the numbers, I would have just written the 14766, and then I would have seen that there are two places here, one place here, so my final answer should end up with three places after the decimal point. So again, you could just do the lattice method without filling in your decimal points and write the whole number and then decide where the decimal point goes. All right, how about trying another one on your own? All right, let's try this one. 1.532 times 3.6, and go ahead and try that using the lattice method on your own by putting the video on pause and trying it on your own first. All right, so first we've got 4 digits by 2 digits. So I'm going to do the 4 across the top, but remember you can do it the other way. Just put the box sideways. So you have two numbers across the top. Usually it's easier to put the bigger number across the top. There's less numbers to add up in the diagonals. You might notice that. Okay, so we've got 1.532 3.6. Let's see where the decimals meet. They meet right here, right? This one comes down, this one comes across. They meet right here. You follow it down, and that's where the decimal's going to be. And now we just go ahead and fill in all the multiplications here. We're going to have 8 different things to multiply here. So let's fill that in. That's 3. That's 15. That's 9. That's 6. Notice I'm not putting all the zeros, but you can fill in the zeros there. Got 18, 30, and 6. So you could leave it like that, or if you feel like it, you could put all the zeros in. Okay, there we go. All right, and then we just drop them in. So that's a 2, 6, 1, and 8. That's 15. I'm going to write that as 1, 5. 9, 1, and 1. That's 10, 11. So I'm going to write that as 11. 5 and 3 is 8, plus there's 7 here, so that's a 15. And 1, 3, and 1 is 5. So it looks like my answer is, reading it around, 5.5152. That seems reasonable because in my original problem, if you just estimate the whole number, it's like a number a little bit bigger than 1, but it's 1 times 3. It's going to be a little bit bigger than 1 times 3, and it's 5. If you got 55, you'd been way off, right? If you had the decimal in the wrong place. Also notice there's three places after the decimal point here and one place. So 3 and 1 is 4. So in my answer, there should also be 4 places after the decimal point. Right, let's do the problem one more time. We already got the answer, 5.5152, putting the 1.532 across the top. Now, how about doing it 3.6 across the top and 1.532 down along the side and see if you get the same answer. So let's figure out where the decimal point's going to end up first. So the two decimal points meet here. You go down and across. It meets here, so that's where the decimal point is going to be. And now let's go ahead and fill in everything else. 3 times 1, 3. 6 times 1, 6. 6 times 5, 30. 3 times 5, 15. 6 times 3, 18. 3 times 3, 9. 6 times 2, 12. And 3 times 2 is 6. So we've got 2, then we've got 8, 1, and 6. So that's 15. So I'm going to put 1, 5. We have 1, 9, and 1. That's 11. So I'm going to put 11 like that. We have 6, 3, 5, and 1. So that's 9, 10, 15. 3, 1, and 1 is 5. And 0, we don't need to write down. And if we read Starting top left and going around, we have 5.512. Same answer. So now you know how you could use a lattice to do multiplication with decimals. And of course, you could just put the whole numbers in here and then just decide at the end where the decimal place goes based on how many digits are after each decimal point in the original problem. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.